स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर अल्कोहल फिनॉल्स एंड ईथर्स. फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी रिएक्शंस ऑफ फिनॉल. फ्रॉम रिएक्शन ऑफ फिनॉल, एज यू रिमेंबर, फिनॉल ऑलवेज अंडरगोज इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन more easily as compared to benzene, because the OH group in phenol is ring activating and ortho para directing group. Students, OH group means hydroxyl group in phenol is ring activating and ortho para directing group. That's why phenol undergo electrophilic substitution reaction more easily as compared to benzene. The first reaction of phenol which we are going to study is halogenation of phenol. As you all of you know, there are four halogen: chlorine, bromine, iodine and fluorine. We are using here bromine as an example. Same reaction is carried out with chlorine also, as bromine react with the phenol. Means chlorine and bromine react in the same way with the phenol. See, in this reaction phenol react with aqueous solution of bromine to give 2,4,6 tribromophenol. Here, 6 bromines are there, from which 3 are attached on the position of 2, 4 and 6. From where hydrogen is removed, means hydrogen is replaced by bromine, and out of 6 bromine, 3 are attached on the ring and remaining 3 react with hydrogen form 3HBr, and the product is 2,4,6 tribromophenol. So it is the reaction when phenol react with aqueous solution of bromine. If the reaction is carried out in a solvent of lower polarity than water, for example CHCl3 means chloroform, CCl4 carbon tetrachloride, CH2 carbon disulfide. So in this case the product is mixture of ortho and para bromophenol. See the example of this reaction. Phenol react with bromine in presence of CH2 at low temperature. Mixture of orthobromophenol and parabromophenol is formed. And same here, bromine is attached on the ring and hydrogen is removed from the ring. Always remember, student, in this reaction the condition is reaction is carried out in a solvent of lower polarity than water, and the products are formed, orthobromophenol and parabromophenol. From these two products, always remember, para bromo phenol is the major product, and this reaction is carried out at low temperature. As I explained you, in the same way chlorine can react with phenol. means in place of bromine you can use chlorine also. The next reaction is nitration of phenol, means whenever any of the compound react with nitric acid, the reaction is known as nitration of phenol. And in this reaction, nitro group is attached with the reactant, means NO2 group is attached. In nitration of phenol, two conditions are there. When phenol react with dilute nitric acid at low temperature, it gives mixture of ortho and para nitrophenol. Just see the example. Phenol react with nitric acid. It is the breaking form of nitric acid, means HONO2. When you combine this, it's form HNO3, means nitric acid. In this reaction, dilute nitric acid, we are using dilute nitric acid at low temperature. So the mixture of ortho and para nitrophenol is formed. Same here, hydrogen is replaced by NO2 group at ortho position, and here hydrogen is replaced by NO2 group at para position. It is the one of the condition for nitration of phenol. In the next condition, when phenol react with concentrated nitric acid to form 2,4,6-trinitrophenol, and 2,4,6-trinitrophenol is nothing but known as picric acid. See the example. Always remember, whenever concentrated nitric acid is used, the reaction is carried out in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. And this concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid, the mixture is known as nitrating mixture. So here phenol is react with concentrated nitric acid in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. Here 2,4,6-trinitrophenol or picric acid is formed. Hydrogen atoms are replaced by NO2 group. These three hydrogen react with these three OH and form what? 3H2O, means 3 molecule of H2. So these are the two conditions for nitration of phenol. In first condition, dilute nitric acid is used at low temperature, and the product is the mixture of ortho and para nitrophenol. In second condition, concentrated nitric acid is used in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, and the product is 2,4,6-trinitrophenol. The next reaction is sulfonation of phenol. In sulfonation of phenol, phenol react with concentrated sulfuric acid at room temperature. Whenever phenol react with concentrated sulfuric acid at room temperature, it gives orthophenol sulfonic acid. And whenever phenol react with concentrated sulfuric acid at 373 Kelvin, it gives paraphenol sulfonic acid. Means again, two conditions are there for sulfonation of phenol. In first condition, phenol react with concentrated sulfuric acid at room temperature, so it's form orthophenosulfonic acid or orthophenol sulfonic acid. See here, student, HOSO3H means H2SO4. It is a breaking form of H2SO4, from which SO3H group is attached on the ring and hydrogen is removed from here. React with OH, byproduct is H2O. Orthophenol sulfonic acid at room temperature. At 373 Kelvin, its form reaction is same, only the position is changed. Instead of ortho position, SO3 group is attached on para position. Means paraphenol sulfonic acid. So it is the reaction of phenol, sulfonation of phenol. Again two conditions are there, at room temperature and at 373 Kelvin. The next reaction is Riemer-Thiemann reaction, which is on the scientist name reaction. In this reaction, when phenol is treated with chloroform in aqueous sodium hydroxide solution, phenol is treated with chloroform in aqueous sodium hydroxide solution, intermediated form which on followed by hydrolysis or acid hydrolysis, salicylaldehyde is formed. Just see the reaction. Phenol react with chloroform. Chloroform is attack on the ortho position. NaOH is react with OH. So when chloroform is attack on ortho position, it form CHCl2. One hydrogen is removed from here. React with chlorine. It is the byproduct HCl. And CHCl2 is attached here. When NaOH is attack on OH, so hydrogen is react with OH, form H2O, and sodium is attached with oxygen. I am repeating here, student, chloroform is attack on ortho position, from where hydrogen is removed and react with one of the chlorine atom, and CHCl2 is attached here. NaOH attack on OH, hydrogen is react with OH, form H2O byproduct, and sodium is attached. This intermediate again react with NaOH. This NaOH attack on CHCl2, oxygen is attached here, and one of the chlorine atom is react with Na, it's form NaCl. One of the chlorine atom is react with hydrogen, it's form HCl, and oxygen is attached with CH, means it forms CHO group. Followed by acid hydrolysis, means you can write here in place of H3O plus H plus and H2O. So H plus means acid, means you can use HCl or H2SO4, any one of the acid which you want. So when this compound in which oxygen carry negative charge and sodium carry positive charge undergo acid hydrolysis, it's form salicylaldehyde. Means sodium atom is replaced by hydrogen atom. So this is the reaction which named as Riemer-Thiemann reaction. Student, if carbon tetrachloride is used in place of chloroform, so the product is salicylic acid instead of salicylaldehyde. Now, the next reaction is Cobb reaction. The treatment of, as you know, whenever phenol react with sodium hydroxide, it forms sodium phenoxide. Means NaOH react with attack on OH, from which hydrogen is react with OH, form H2O as a byproduct, and sodium is attached here. So it is sodium phenoxide. So in Cobb's reaction, the treatment of sodium phenoxide with carbon dioxide at 398 Kelvin and 6 atmosphere pressure, which is followed by acid hydrolysis, is formed salicylic acid or ortho hydroxy benzoic acid. And this reaction is known as Cobb's reaction. Means sodium phenoxide, when phenol react with NaOH, it forms sodium phenoxide. It is treated with carbon dioxide, which forms sodium salicylate, followed by acid hydrolysis, it forms salicylic acid. The formula of sodium salicylate is aromatic ring containing OH and at ortho position COONA. Means CO2 is attack on ortho position, so it's formed COONA and hydrogen is removed from here. COONA and hydrogen is removed from here. So this is the Cobb reaction of phenol. The next reaction of phenol is oxidation of phenol. Always remember, student, oxidation means removal of hydrogen and addition of oxygen. Removal of hydrogen and addition of oxygen. Phenol on oxidation with chromic anhydride means CrO3 or sodium dichromate means Na2Cr2O7 in presence of H2SO4 give para-benzoquinone. See the reaction. Phenol undergo oxidation either with chromic anhydride or sodium dichromate in presence of H2SO4, it gives para benzoquinone. As you know, the process is oxidation, so hydrogen is removed from here. If hydrogen is removed from here, so single bond is changed into a double, and the process is oxidation, means addition of oxygen take place. So oxygen is adding here, and as you know, conjugated system, double bond, single bond, then double bond, then single bond, then double bond, then single bond, then double bond, then single bond. I am repeating here, student, removal of hydrogen. So single bond change into a double bond. Addition of oxygen on para position. Then conjugated system. Double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond and single bond. Para benzoquinone is formed. Phenol oxidizes slowly, giving a dark color mixture in presence of air. Always remember. Now, the next reaction is catalytic hydrogenation of phenol. Hydrogenation means addition of hydrogen. As by the name, we can understand hydrogenation, addition of hydrogen. So obviously double bond change into a single bond because valency of carbon is increases. Phenol on catalytic hydrogenation gives cyclohexanol. In this reaction, mixture of vapor of phenol and hydrogen is passed over nickel as a catalyst at 433 Kelvin temperature. 6 hydrogens are there. Each one carbon atom, one hydrogen atom is attached each one of the carbon atom. So valency of carbon is increases and double bond is changed into a single bond and the product is cyclohexanol. Always remember, student, in this reaction, mixture of phenol vapor of phenol and hydrogen is passed over nickel as a catalyst at 433 Kelvin temperature. The next reaction is reduction of phenol. As you all of you know, reduction of phenol means removal of oxygen. The formula of phenol is C6H5OH. If we remove oxygen from the formula, so what is remaining here? It is C6H6 only. So phenol is reduced to benzene and heating with zinc dust. So whenever phenol is heating with zinc dust, it is reduced to benzene and the byproduct is zinc oxide. Student, these are the reactions of phenol. Chemical reactions of phenol. The next topic from this chapter is physical properties of ethers. In this, the first physical property is physical state and boiling point. Physical state and boiling points. The first point in this, dimethyl ether and ethyl methyl ether are gases. Other ethers are colorless liquid with pleasant odor. Second, lower ethers are highly volatile and highly inflammable substance. Third point is, boiling point of ether show gradual increase with increase in molecular mass. As you have seen in this table, boiling point of ether show gradual increase with increase in the molecular mass. Dimethyl ether 248 Kelvin, ethyl methyl ether 284 Kelvin, diethyl ether 308 Kelvin. Next physical property is polarity and solubility. So students, in ether, since carbon oxygen carbon bond angle is 110 degree and not 180 degree, the bond dipole moment of the two CO bond do not cancel each other, Therefore, ether possesses a small net dipole moment. For example, dipole moment of diethyl ether is 1.18 d. Weak polarity of ether does not affect their boiling point, which are about the same as those of alkanes having comparable molecular masses. Students, the intermolecular hydrogen bonding that holds alcohol molecules together strongly is not present in ethers and alkanes. However, solubility of ether in water is similar to that of alcohol of comparable molecular masses. This is because ether can form hydrogen bond with water through the ethereal oxygen. For example, diethyl ether and N-butyl alcohol have respective miscibilities of 7.5 and 9 gram per 100 gram of water. So these are the physical properties of ether, and you have to learn it. For today lecture, these topics are reaction of phenol and physical properties of ethers completed. The next topic means chemical reaction of ether and uses of alcohol, phenol and ether. We will continue in the next lecture. Thank you so much.